Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is my TJ Maxx and Marshall's shop with me. And this week was so insane with all the finds. I swear we were at a Sephora store instead of TJ Maxx with all the stuff we found. Lots of exciting things are hitting the stores right now and I couldn't be any more happier. So we have a lot to go over. And also, if you guys are looking for Halloween decor, my stores just started putting Halloween decor in. So I would definitely check by next week. I feel like it's gonna be full-fledged Halloween, especially once August 1st hits. It's definitely gonna go nuts. I always love TJ Maxx Halloween decor and you kind of have to grab it first or else it's gonna be sold out pretty quickly. So anyways, let's go ahead and get into the video.
First thing here at the stores, I am seeing some new stuff. Firstly, I want to point out these hiding behind here. We have the full-size Becca highlighter. This is in the shade Vanilla Quartz, one of my favorite shades from them. I own this in the mini size, and we have seen the mini here, but I don't think we've seen the full size yet, so very cool. This is going for $12.99. Definitely get to your stores if you want to stock up on Becca before it is gone, but I don't know. We might keep seeing a lot of their stuff here. Also, we have from Mineral Fusion. We've seen an eyeshadow palette from them at the stores. I'm not super familiar with this brand, but we have a pressed powder foundation for $5.99 in Warm 2. It says buildable coverage, satin finish. These are all in number Warm 2. I'm also seeing a lot of stuff from the Creme Shop. We'll start off with this. This is the Toasty Cushion Bronzer. I wonder if it looks like a toast. I'll have to insert a photo, but it has a little toast here. The Creme Shop is a brand I don't really try a lot of their stuff, but it is very affordable. This is for $5.99. And that one said it is for fair skin tones. There's another one here for medium skin tones as well. You have to look at the side for the color. And then from also the Creme Shop, we have these cute little blushes or highlights, I guess. It looks like a blush, but it says Aurora Powder Highlighter, a little heart-shaped packaging in a Super Stellar for $3.99. Definitely think you could use that as a blush. Here is a good highlight one. This is Light Years. A little more on the gold side for sure. Here's another one in Rosé Day. This is a Moncherry Powder Blush. I think we have seen these before. And then there's this blue highlighter as well in a Moonshine. And I believe that is all of the Creme Shop stuff. Now we'll get into some new Stila. I'm seeing more of their lipsticks that I showed last week. I only saw a couple shades, but now they have quite a few more. So these are the Shine Fever Lip Vinyls. So they're actually kind of like a glossy liquid lip. So they're not like matte or anything like that. These are $5.99. I bought one last week if you guys want to see it in action. I have Horsepower, Full Throttle, and Speedway. So they're all named after like racing things. I bought the shade Turbo. And then up here, I'm actually seeing more Stila glosses. I'm very intrigued by this one. It's so pretty, it looks sparkly. So these are the Beauty Boss lip glosses. We've seen these here before in just a couple shades that were kind of crazy ones, but we have Blue Sky and then Strategy, which looks like a good neutral for $4.99. And then from BH, this is new, the Cashmere Cream Comfort Lipstick in the shade T. There's a couple of them just in this shade so far for $2.99. And then up here, there's lots of new stuff. I guess keep going and going. This is again from Mineral Fusion. We have the liquid foundation from them in Warm 4 Tawny. And that one is $5.99. There is a ton more K-Beauty stuff. The Creme Shop stuff is K-Beauty, so they must have got like a shipment together. But they also have Etude, which I'm familiar with Etude House. I think it's basically the same thing. But we have these slim pencil liners from Etude. This is in Pearl Brown for $4.99. Also this Natural Tinting Mascara for $4.99. This is a Drawing Eyes Slim Pencil Liner again in Caramel Brown. Also the shade Dark Brown. This is kind of a crazy find. This is from BH's holiday collection last year, but we have this Fan Brush Eye Trio. So not any makeup, but we do have the brushes from it, which is really cool. I was so close to buying that eyeshadow palette. It got really good reviews. I hope to see it here. This is for $4.99 and there's other brushes included, but they also have a ton more BH sets, including their Eye Essential 7-piece brush set. This is $5.99, and this one looks gorgeous, the Opalusion. I remember we did see this palette here a while ago, the Opalusion Dreamy 8-piece brush set. This is $12.99, and another brush set is the Sculpt and Blend 10-piece as well, which is $12.99. So definitely the most shocking is this one from the holiday collection, because that was a pretty popular one. Looks like they have a bunch more Morphe brushes down there, which we went over last week. And then from Smashbox, we have a powder foundation brush. Honestly, looks more like a liquid foundation brush, but this is $14.99. I'm kind of curious about this because I never know what brush to use with my powder foundation. So it seems like this one might give pretty good coverage. And then here is that NYX like Lunar New Year palette. We saw an eyeliner from them last week and I was wondering if there was gonna be more in this collection. So this is the Ultimate Shadow Palette. It's called Warm Neutrals. I feel like this is a palette they always have, but maybe different packaging, because I'm pretty sure they always have this palette. This is for $6.99. I remember people used to rave about these, so it's probably pretty good. And then I just spotted this as well from BH. I hope we see more of their palettes here. I love their travel series. This is a highlight palette, the Illuminating into Ireland, 6-color palette. This is going for $7.99. I did find this from Kevin Aquan here. It looks like it was an online return, so this might not be in stores, but maybe online you guys can look for this. It's the Foundation Balm from them in Medium FB105. This is going for $19.99. I've never tried this. I feel like I heard mixed reviews on it though. I'm not sure if it was like good or not or what the situation is, but I did figure I would show this. Maybe you guys can look for it online if you're interested. All right, this is an awesome find here from Buxom. This is totally new here. The Full Force Plumping lipsticks are at TJ Maxx. I found 3 so far, but I feel like we're gonna see all of them. So we have Popstar, Supermodel, and Angel. Now that I'm looking at this, this is actually the 90s collection. So I have the full collection already. There is like 6 of them. So it's not the originals. I don't know if we'll still see that, but these are really pretty shades. If you want that like 90s nude brown type of vibe, you should definitely check these out. These are $6.99 and I love the formula on these. So such a good find. Highly recommend these lipsticks from Buxom, and they're fairly new too. Here's one more in that collection called Dreamboat. So pretty much the whole 90s collection is here. I keep discovering these everywhere, but this must be the last one in Fly Girl. So we found, it looks like, 5 different shades. I am seeing a bunch of restocks on the Cover FX Custom Cover Drop Foundation. This is going for $6.99. They have a bunch of different shades, but then I found something else from them that is really exciting that we haven't seen, and it is the Power Play Concealer. This used to be very hyped. I don't know what is going on with Cover FX. I just never see new stuff from them these days, but this is one of their best products. I might actually pick this up. It's in Enfair 1, so it should work for me. I'll have to see if there's any more, but so far I just found this one color. But this is such a good concealer. I had it back in the day. I believe I used it up, and it's only $5.99, which is a steal for this. But yeah, they have lots more of the Custom Cover Drop Foundation too at a very affordable price. And we'll see if we find more shades in the concealer. It's another double wear shade. I think we found the shades 3 last week, but this one's shade 2C3 Fresco. So 2 is going to be pretty light. C means cool undertone. Again, this is, I think, $19.99. I did see a new Kate Somerville cleanser here too. This is the Goat Milk Cleanser, so very moisturizing. This is $16.99. Looks like we have a new Sephora skincare product here as well. We always see their stuff here from time to time. This is the Hemp Mousse Mask from them. This is going for only $2.99. Over in the body care, I had to point this out because this is a really cool find, but they have Scentworks here. This is by Harry Slatkin's line. He's actually the like original maker of the Bath & Body Works Slatkin candles from back in the day, and they have like a body care line usually at Kohl's, so that has to be where this came from. This is the Golden Vanilla Shower Gel for $4.99, and they also have this one, which is Rose Water Rain. So very cool to see the Scentwork stuff here. I would love to see their candles. That would be amazing. I also have a bunch of these L'Occitane sets, which I'm really curious about. These are $24.99. It says it has the Happy Cherry Shower Gel full size and a Happy Cherry Body Milk as well. Kind of curious about trying this. I love L'Occitane stuff, but it's so expensive. It looks like someone opened one over here. I'm just curious what this, oh wow, that's cute. I kind of want to try this. Maybe I'll pick it up. I'm a huge sucker for L'Occitane and just like try it out. It's about $12 per item, which isn't too bad. I noticed a new brand in the hair area. We have a bunch of Diva Curl. I haven't seen this here before, but I thought I would mention it. I know they had some drama in the past couple years, so I don't know if I would necessarily recommend it, but I did want to share. They have the One Condition Delight like liter size for $19.99. There's a No Poo Blue Anti-It Brass. This is $9.99. The Archangel Gel, $9.99. This is the Flexible Hold Hairspray. Pretty much all this stuff is $9.99, so I won't do the prices. This is the Frizz-Free Volumizing Foam. They have the Super Mousse as well. And I think that is everything, so pretty much a lot of their stuff is showing up here. Notice another Sephora product here in the hair section, and it is their Sephora Hair Semi-Permanent Hair Color. It reminds me a lot of the ones from Moroccan Oil. This is the Tenacious Teal. So if you guys like to change your hair a lot, it's temporary. It's only $3.99. That's kind of what it's supposed to look like. And they have these down here as well. This is the Sephora Hair. It just says shampoo. It has flamingos on it. So I guess it's just a basic one, I don't know. This is $4.99. They also have the conditioner as well. And then this other Sephora hair product is an air dry styling cream. Kind of intrigued about this one. Also going for $4.99. And this shocked me, it's a mini, but we have Way hair care here. Never seen their brand here before, but they might have got a shipment in from Sephora. This is the dry shampoo foam, mini size. It's going for $10.99. Not sure if that would be worth it for this little amount, but really cool to see. In the perfume section, they did add in the Britney Spears Fantasy perfume. I just did a celebrity perfumes video with my top 10, which this is included, so I'll link that down below. But this is a tiny size, it's 0.5, but it's great if you just want to try it. It's only $8.99, so very cheap, super sweet, delicious scent. Here's another MAC mascara that they have. We found the Hot and Naughty one last week. This is the Extended Play Perm Me Up. Let's see. I don't see a price on this one. I feel like the other one might have been like $9.99. Here it is. I see that this is actually the box for it, or it has like an outside part, so it's $12.99 for that, and it's supposed to look like this. So that goes in here. I'm so excited about these finds as well. These are from the Sephora collection at Marshall's here. I see something else exciting back there, but these are the I Love palettes. I think these came out last year or a couple years back. I found two, light cool and light warm, for $4.99 each. This is what the colors look like. I'll have to give you guys a better photo of each one, but so cool to see these here from Sephora collection. I feel like they had pretty decent reviews. And then they also have this gloss kit, which is the Give Me Some Sugar. I don't even remember seeing this before. Looks like a holiday one maybe, but it's like a little candy theme. There's three different colorful glosses, and this is for $5.99. I found one more. This one is the medium warm one as well. So far I found three of these. I'm not sure how many there is in the total collection. We did see these before as well, but they have quite a few of them in too, from Sephora, the House of Lashes, in Amelia for $4.99. I did find one more style over here called Valentina. So there is a couple different ones that have different colors on them. Like this one's pink, the other one was blue. They also have a ton of velour lashes here. I thought I would share because these weren't here last time, but they are synthetic lashes. I know they sell them, I believe, at Ulta and Sephora. These are $7.99 each. This is the Fluffin' Wispy. This next one is Worst Behavior. This style here, this is the Fluff and Cool. And I think that is all of them. So we saw three different styles. I thought this Pacifica product was kind of cool here at Marshall's. They have the Cherry Matte Setting Spray. I know they have a Cherry Matte Powder that people say is like a dupe for the Too Faced. This is going for $4.99. Also spotted this Pixie Bronzer as well. It's the Beauty Bronzer plus Kabuki here. This is in the shade Summertime. It's going for $6.99. And that's kind of what it looks like. So I believe this is one with the twist off cap. Another Sephora palette here. This one looks like it's a face palette. So this one is called Illuminate from Sephora. It's going for $9.99. There's six different shades in here. Looks like highlights, maybe bronzer possibly as well. Some you could probably use as blush. So lots of Sephora popping up. This is also back in the stores again from Cover Effects. We saw these like a year or more ago, so it's been a minute. It's the Spotlight Loose Powder Highlighter in Glam. This is going for $7.99. It has two different shades, I believe. I also found this humongous palette here from BH. We've been seeing a lot of their stuff here, so I'm looking for more of the travel collection, but we did see this Santa Fe eyeshadow palette. It has this kind of crazy design. This is going for $7.99 and you get 20 different shadows. Oh, I see something really exciting. This is from Lime Crime. How cool. This is the Aura palette. I haven't seen this anywhere yet. This is going for $12.99. It's an eye and face palette. It looks like it's multicolored. I'm seeing the sticker kind of covered it, but there's a few different colors on top. It looks like a pink, a blue, and a purple so far, but how fun. I always love finding new lime crime stuff here, so this is an awesome find. I just found one more of these. It's called Glory, and this one you can kind of see the shades a bit more. So it actually has 9 shades in here total. They're like little squares. This is going for $12.99. I haven't bought much lime crime in so long, so I'm wondering about the quality of these, but it's still cool to see. They just look pretty like plain for lime crime. Usually they're pretty out there. And then over here, they do have one lime crime lip product. I'm surprised we don't see more yet, but maybe more is on the way. This is the Flamingo Cherry Wet Cherry Glosses. I really like this formula. They smell really good too. This is for $6.99. They also have this Lime Crime Plushie, which is one of their like velvet lip colors. This is going for $6.99 in this shade Sorbet. I just found more of these Lime Crime glosses too. We have a nude and unripe cherry and then a sour cherry. So lots of fun colors. And then they also have some new shades in the Velveteens here, which is like their super matte liquid lipstick. We have the shade Lulu, Buffy, and then Paulette. These are more on the drying side. These are $6.99 each. They also restocked on the Sephora Clean and Cover foundations. We did see these before, but since we're seeing a lot of the brand, I guess they brought in a lot more shades here. This is only $3.99. It has 2% salicylic acid in the formula, so it might be good for acne prone skin. I just found this new Lorac palette here as well. It's the Unzipped Unfiltered. This is another one I haven't really heard of. I kind of haven't paid attention to their palettes since the original Unzipped, but this is only $7.99. I do think it is one of their smaller ones, so you do only get 5 shades in here. But I'll go ahead and insert a photo if you guys are interested and are going to be on the hunt for this one, because it is a really good deal. And Lorac does have pretty good shadow quality as well. I also found one more of those Sephora Eye Love palettes. This time it's at TJ Maxx, so we should be seeing more of these at both the stores. This one is in Deep Warm for, again, $4.99. We finally have a new product from Benefit here. It's been a while since we've seen them at the stores, but this is the Porefessional. It's a shine control powder from them. I've never seen this product. This is going for $14.99. It says mattifying, pore perfecting, invisible finish, and that's kind of what it looks like. It has the little brush and powder inside, so very cool to see that. Hopefully that means we will see more from Benefit on the way. This might be new too from Pixi in the skincare section. We have the Glotion Day Dew. It has lavender oil and mica in the formula. It's supposed to be a glowy moisturizer. This is for $5.99. Also, in the body care section, I'm kind of obsessed with Hello Kitty, so I had to share this. The Crumb Shop always has different Hello Kitty items, but they have this Crystal Cleanse Sugar Body Scrub. It's a lavender scent, and it's only $4.99. Okay, remember I said earlier that I was wondering if we would see the Homeworks candles, and I just found one so far in their Halloween section. So they're really bringing out Halloween now in full force. Definitely check, because after August 1st, it's going to be crazy, and I think we'll definitely see more of these candles. You can find them at Ulta. I don't know if Kohl's has them, but they're very popular. I found the Spice Vanilla Pumpkin one, and this is very heavy. It's $14.99. It has notes of pumpkin, warm caramel, vanilla bean, and blood orange. I think I'm actually going to pick this up. I'm super excited to find it.
All right, I do have a little haul for you guys. I tried not to go too crazy, even though it was hard, because there was some really good stuff that I kind of wanted. But I tried to get things I know I will use. So first being, I did pick up that Cover FX concealer. I still only found one so far. Sometimes that happens, but I feel like we're gonna get a huge shipment of this in soon. I used to love this stuff, so I've been out of it for a while. I picked up the Enfair 1 shade. It does look pretty light, so we'll see how it goes. It should be fine though. I do have some self-tan on now, so I look a little bit more tan than usual. But this stuff used to be so good, like a nice full coverage concealer. I hope that Cover FX makes a comeback, because I used to like a lot of their products. The next thing I bought was this candle. I was so excited to find Homeworks by Harry Slatkin there, because Slatkin & Co., I kind of talked about this earlier, was the old Bath & Body Works manufacturer of their candles. So they used to make all the OG scents. This one smells amazing too. So I only saw one so far, but I feel like we're going to see more too, like the whole fall line. The price was a little bit expensive for $14.99, but this is a 4-wick candle, and I think they do burn longer than Bath & Body Works. So that's what it looks like, and you get, does it say the ounce size on here somewhere? I don't see it right away. This smells so good, you guys. This reminds me a lot of Caramel Apple from Bath & Body Works. So good. It's not what I would expect, because I don't get like any pumpkin out of this, but I get caramel apple, but it smells amazing. I cannot wait to burn this, my first Slatkin Homeworks candle. Hopefully we see more. And then I did buy some lashes because I go through lashes like crazy, always need them. And I found these really nice velour ones at Marshall's. I picked up two of the styles. This one is Worst Behavior, and these usually last a pretty good amount. Like, you can use them a few times. They're a nice sturdy lash. And then I also got the Fluff and Cool ones, which are kind of crazy. Both of these are a little crazy for me, but I'm hoping I will like them on with like a really nice full glam look. And yes, that is going to complete this TJ Maxx haul. It was definitely hard for me not to buy any of the new lime crème stuff I saw today. That was nuts. Definitely head to your store soon because they are getting some really good stuff in. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out on all the new arrivals at TJ Maxx. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.